Hey Christian, what's up? No, man, no. No, 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 no. No, no, no. It's not a demotion. It's not a demotion. It's a really important competition. Listen. Hello? That's not good. Hello, my friends. Welcome in. It's episode 5. I'm going to be trying to show you some new features, or theoretically new features. I've never had an international stave have the capability of doing under 23 qualifying for the Olympics. That could be just because it wasn't timed right with my saves, or maybe my nations already had an under 23 manager, but I don't recall being given the option. It gave me the option to say, hey, do you want to manage this or hire somebody? And so we've gone with trying to do it ourselves. I also love that I've got a C plus. They're satisfied. They are happy with my our convincing 3-0 win over Canada. But like, you know, C plus over Cuba, B plus over Canada, a competition performance. They don't regard the Nations League to be important. We don't have any goals, you know, like. It's just kind of strange, right? Like, there should be some goals here. So, all that to say, I wanted to show you this screen, the under 23 squad to be decided. So, it didn't give me any heads up. So, it wasn't like, hey, this is upcoming. It was on the schedule, so I could see it coming. And I didn't want to call players up too early because I was afraid, like, if there was an under 20 match or an under 19 match or something like that, they wouldn't be able to get called up to both because they'd already technically be in the under 23 squad. So, I just left it. I think we had Tim Weah, Austin Trustee, and somebody else already in this squad. But as you can see and from the intro there, we have called up some interesting players, in my opinion. So I want to walk you through those, to be honest with you. Let's go take a look at it from, oh, that's the wrong squad. Here we go. From this window. From a goalkeeper standpoint, you must have 3. They must be under 23. I thought with Olympic qualifying, it was you could have like 1 or 2 over 23 players, but maybe they've changed the rule, or maybe it's different in qualifying. Not sure. And why would I look that up? because it's going to say down here, right? I do like that you can kind of see here that it rules for Olympic qualifications, match against Honduras. And it tells you, okay, that you can't see the numbers because I'm one night, but it's like 0 is the maximum of 0 over 23 players born before 1/1/1997. 3, minimum of 3 goalkeepers in the squad. 23, maximum squad size. 23, minimum squad size of 19 is the kind of the numbers here. And so if you're going into a competition, you're like, hey, do I have enough players registered, or is my registration stuff correct? Like, you know, Champions League, as an example, not internationally, right? Where you have to have a certain number of homegrown players and homegrown nation versus homegrown club players and so on and so forth. It's got the checklist down here for you, which is quite handy, to be honest with you. It's not on a separate like registration screen for this. Now, maybe for Champions League, it would be different, but at least it shows you on the squad screen as you're building your squad, and you can look at all the, you know, star ratings and all that kind of stuff of your players. You can kind of get an idea of, like, am I calling up the right kind of player? So, all that to say, our under 23 goalkeeping situation is dire, my friends. If you go to the national pool, all I did, I added age to our international selection list here, so I could go like, okay, find me some goalkeepers under 23, and you just start going down, and the first one is Jonathan Klinsmann, but he's got a hip injury between 6 weeks and 4 months, so he definitely would have been called up, but he is not available. Justin Vomsteeg is the next one, but he has really low potential ability, so it's kind of like you're already getting what you're going to get with him, so I said nah. So Trey, and there was also, I took into consideration stuff like he's not played any, right? He's a backup for the Colorado Rapids versus Trey Muse here. Has 28 starts, 32 conceded, 8 clean sheets in MLS. So at least he's playing, which I kind of find hard to believe. Is he playing for Seattle? Like, is he Seattle's goalkeeper? What is this? Okay, I guess so. He's a homegrown player at the club. 35 appearances, 30 appearances. I don't know how that works, but It says he's playing, so that was kind of the decider, to be honest with you. So I did bring Justin because he's all right. It's really kind of sad. Carl Pressley has some decent potential and is playing for FC Dallas Juniors, so he's playing, but not at any kind of level. You know, like it's kind of not great, let's be honest. I could bring like Brady Scott instead of Justin, but they're all, I mean, I might actually take a look here. He's got 5 league appearances. Really? Oh, it's for the reserves. He is playing in Germany, though. Kind of like that. Matt Fries, 3 starts, 8 conceded on 6-0-3 for the Philadelphia Union. Not going to call that up. Sorry. I like David Ochoa, if that's how you say it, but he's just not playing yet. Got some good potential, but he's just not playing. So in terms of under 23 qualifying, I thought, no. I think we may take Justin out here. He looks pretty good, but nah, he's got better first touch and all that kind of stuff. All right, so anyway, that's a really long time on the goalkeeper. Sorry about that. Our center back situation, or defender situation, brought quite a few. We got Cameron Carter-Vickers, who just got sent off. Or no, he had a yellow card with a penalty conceded in real life recently. Go on, CCV. Justin Glad, who I'm quite excited about. 3-star with 4-star potential. And I'll show you what the guys I'm really excited about. He is not cap tied. I don't think under 23 will cap tie him, but like, mate, like, hopefully it shows you, right? Like, hey, we love you. CCV is cap tied. Austin Trusty, who's not cap tied. He may be declared though. Let's check. Nope, but he has no other nationality, so we're not as worried about him. But he does look to be pretty good. I like him as a, I mean, he's 21. I mean, potentially 4.5-star potential, right? Like, that's pretty legitimate. I am bringing Reggie Cannon. He's got a concussion for the next 7 days. Our first game is in 6 days, but there are 2 other games after that. So I want to give Reggie more opportunities to get out there and show his team he can play. Come on, FC Dallas. Eric Palmer Brown, which is a name that I've heard battered around in the U.S. men's national team conversation for a couple years. 6 league starts, but it's for some loan club. I mean, he's playing in Austria. See, I know it's Austria, but he played in Holland and got 18 starts, you know, and he's playing on a 6.97 thus far this season. Not bad. Tyler Adams, again, not really a defender. I mean, he could be. He's covering right back as well for us and playing midfield, but that's the beautiful thing about – that's the beautiful and the terrible thing about the U.S. men's national team is all the players are so young. Like, we're missing the 24 to 28-year-old generation, which is a long story. And the reason I mention that is I've had some people be like, this is fascinating. I know nothing about the U.S. situation, right? So that's why they've been kind of bad, is like we've got a really good group of young prospects coming through, as you can see. And we have, like, Josie Altidore and Michael Bradley and Darlington Nagme, who's not getting called in. So, like, there's a huge... like, the thing in the middle, we just lost, like, a whole generation. But Tyler Adams, being 20, can play in the under-23s. And I thought I would test this out now, because in our first window, we play Cuba. So I'm really hoping this doesn't tie these guys down for the entire qualification campaign, because that would be bad for the Nations League. But our next window, which coincides with this, we're playing a friendly and Cuba. So I'm like, okay, we can afford to get, like, to have Tyler Adams, Reggie Cannon, Weston McKennie, Christian Pulisic, Timothy Weah come play with the under-23s. Like, I'm fairly confident that at home against Cuba, we can play with our rotational guys with the senior team. So, Chris Durkin, who is a 19-year-old, he was with DC United, but they've loaned him to Sint-Truidense, which is in the Jupiler Pro League, which is what? Is that the Netherlands? That's the Netherlands, right? You know, that's Belgium. I guess I don't have Belgium loaded. I tried to load all the places that I thought players would be at. I didn't realize we had Chris Durkin there. So That's kind of disappointing for his development. He's got 8 starts on a 6-8-9, but is he really going to develop? Anthony Robinson, again, our one of our left backs, you know, playing at the championship level. Chris Gloucester, who is playing for the Las Vegas Lights, my friends, in the, I think it's USL or one of the lower leagues. But, you know, doing all right. Now, I'm kind of curious because he moved on a free to FC Cold and they loaned him back to the U.S. Not sure what the situation is there. Alex Mendez, who you all had mentioned in the comments to go try and snag at Ajax. Let's see. He's not declared. We're trying to... Oh, boy. Oh, no. Okay. I thought that was days left. Whew. Okay. West McKinney, we already know. Brendan Aronson looks to be pretty good midfielder, attacking midfielder, but very versatile. I like that the versatility on the team. We can rotate these guys around. I hope this is interesting to you because I'm 10 minutes into recording and we're showing players. Jonathan Amon, who is somebody that you all recommended in the comments. And I'm aware of Jonathan. I think he is actually captain. He played for us. No, he's not. It must have been a friendly with Peru. Decision-making is a little nervy. Concentration, mental strength needs some work. But he's 20 years old. So, hey, man, we're thinking of you. We want you in the squad. Let's go qualify for the Olympics because we've not done that for the last 2 Olympics. That's the other thing. That's why I'm showing this to you. Gianluca Busio here, looking pretty good. 17 years old, has Italian nationality. So we've got to, again, I was thinking with some of these guys, but, let's call him up against Cuba. But he's 17. You know, like, there is a line where you just can't, you don't want to just be like, cap tie every single person. Because that's not really great for their career if you're never going to use them. But you want to cap tie the really good ones that have potential. Again, he's got potential, but he's 17. So I want to give him just a little bit. Maybe we get him in the last window for the Nations League. Handwala Bwana, which is a fantastic name. 2.5 star. I've never heard of this kid. Apparently plays for the Sounders or USL squad? It's not Seattle, too. It's called something else. I think it's in a different part of Washington. That's going to bother me, but he's got 20 starts, 8 subs, 2 goals, 3 assists, and a 6-8-1. Quite good. Again, not cap tied, and has, Kenyan nationality. So we're trying to show him that we're interested. Obviously we know Christian Pulisic. We showed you, Ulysses here where Jeremy Ebobese, from Portland, he's got okay, that's interesting. Through 2017 through 2019, 34 starts, 4 goals. Not great. 6 starts, 5 subs, a goal, 3 assists, and a 6-8-7. 6 feet tall, target man, strong, 22. Is already declared for, so we don't have to worry about captaining him in the next window. And then Josh Sargent. So that's kind of what I was thinking with those guys. So if you look at it, what am I thinking here? From a tactic standpoint, right now, this is kind of where we would line up. So it's a lot of the folks we already know, right? Sargent, Weah, Pulisic, Adams, McKinney, Chris Durkin taking that DM spot, Reggie Cannon on the right, Austin Trusty, and CCV holding down the midfield, Robinson. So essentially, like, these 3 players are new, but it's all of a bench after that is kind of like folks, aside from, let's see, Lana's here, everybody else would be new coming into the squad. So that's kind of what we're doing here. I'm going to go ahead and lock this in. There may be players that you've mentioned in the meantime that I haven't seen the comment yet because I'm recording. I like that Mendez said, yeah, we'll come do it. So we're going to hop forward to whenever that is, fixtures, which is in 6 days. I just want to show you that the selection screen is just like the international selection screen, but now we've already kind of taken a look at the squad. And we'll come back for, theoretically, the Honduras under-23s. Let's go. Also, I want to show you, this is who we're calling up for the next senior team window, because obviously those call-ups for the under-23s will impact this pretty significantly. So look at the squad. You got Altidore, Jordan Morris, Paul Areola on the attacking third, Dwayne Holmes taking the midfield, Darlington Nagby, Michael Bradley. So kind of your rotational players, minus Altidore here. Fabian holding down the left back spot, Brooks, Miazga, and Yedlin. So all familiar faces there with Zach Steffen in goal. For the friendly, that we're going to play beforehand against Holland. We're probably going to play three at the back. Maybe. It just seems like a bad idea now that I've verbalized it. Because here's what I'm thinking, right? So we've called up Horvath and Sean Johnson. Sean's got a 703. He's in form for NYCFC in MLS. Good goalkeeper to have in the squad. And then let's just go through the names of the players that we're trying to cap tie. So Matt Olasunde, Brian Okoa, James Sands, Keaton Parks, I think, is already cap tied. Gianluca Busio, Emmanuel Sabi, and Fulleran Balogun, who some of these guys I've never heard of. I've heard of James Sands, I've heard of Keaton Parks and Busio, and I think Sabi, but some of these I've not heard of. But the problem is I didn't call up another left back. So, or we could play, I guess, this against Holland. And I mean, we should be able to beat Cuba, right? And play like a 3-4-3 or something like that against Cuba. You know, it's always good to, you know, to randomly come up with formation changes on the fly. But let's look at these guys. Matt Olasunde is a right back slash he could play center back, but he's really a right back. Two stars playing for Rotherham. He's got 9 starts and a goal and a 6-7-8. Not terrible, not great, but he's got great potential. 21 years old. We want to cap tie him down. We know Aaron Long. Brian Okoa has, I think, Swiss, which I thought was interesting. Swiss heritage. So, but I like, he's got 20 determination. He's either-footed. Anytime you see an either-footed center back, I'm like, boom, lock that guy down. So he will probably start against Cuba. I just have a thing where it's like, if you got a left-footed center back, that's you on the left side, that's great. You got a right-footed on the right. So if you got a guy that can play both, that is unbelievable. And I don't care that he's 16 and he has 2 stars. James Sands is, it says his natural position is a DM. I thought I've heard him playing for the under 19, under 20, the whole setup for like 2 World Cups as a center back, but it could be wrong. But he knows pretty much the spine of the defense. I love that. So we definitely want to cap tie him. I don't think, he doesn't have any other, but like, I think it's not just cap tying, but like, I think he's a good player, right? And he's going to continue to develop. So again, we're playing Cuba and Holland, but I think he's worth bringing into the squad for sure. Kellen Acosta, I think we've seen him before here, you know, decent player, moved to the Colorado Rapids because he kind of fell out completely with FC Dallas, which was kind of sad. Having like, I think he played their youth squad and all that kind of stuff. He moves to Colorado and it's kind of, I mean, Colorado is a terribly run organization. Keaton Parks, who is with Benfica and on loan at Sondrisk, of course, is how you say it. He's, I think he's already he's not cap tied. So that's why he played against Bolivia in, like when we played Bolivia's D team. And there's all this talk about, he's with Benfica and whatever. And he's kind of, it's kind of not turned out into much of anything this far, but he's got great potential in FM. So we're going to play him. Gianluca Busio that we talked about. I love the versatility. Again, can play in the attacking midfield, can play in the midfield if we need him to, that type of situation. Jordan Sabachu that we already know. Emmanuel Sabi is a striker slash could play on the wing if we need him to. Looks pretty good. Playing for Hobro. Again, this was a recommendation from the comments, so thank you for that. Whoever that was, I can't remember in this moment. I didn't look it up before I started recording. And then Fulleran Balogun, contracted to Arsenal, has Nigerian and England as potential places that he could play for, and we've got him. We got him early, my friends. He will start against Cuba. So again, I'll figure that out when we get there in terms of the formation. But we may go against Holland with this formation and most of these players. Like maybe we play Jordan up top. I'm not sure because he's in really good form. And then against Cuba, because you don't want to have like all of the under 20 players playing against Cuba. You want to have some sort of mix of, you know, experience. So like maybe bring an Altidore in against Cuba. Depending on the formation, honestly, if we play like a 3-4-3, have Kellen Acosta start that game, or maybe have Kellen Acosta start against Holland and Bradley start against the other one to kind of give, again, kind of give a balance to the squad. But I thought I'd show that to you as well because the under 23 call-ups impact this. I know it's been 15 minutes of call-ups, but I wanted to show you the squad and kind of walk through my thinking here, so hopefully you're still with us. Of course, now everyone's mad because I put them in the under 23 squad, which I thought might happen, but it's a lot. So, I just want to be like, you're going to go qualify for the Olympics. We have to qualify for the Olympics. Oh, I made everybody mad. Oh, no. I guess I didn't think about how it would be a demotion to the under 23s. But I just, honestly, it's like, we literally have not qualified for the Olympics in two Olympics. So, mate, you're under 23, you qualify, let's go. Unless it means that he's now tied to that competition the entire time, in which case, this is a disaster. I think we found a bug, my friends. I suggest we pick the following team for Thursday's match against the Honduras under 23s. That's a pretty good looking team. And it's like, we do have a tactic. We've got players selected, so that is a bug. So I'm going to save the game and send it up as a report. We have been hammered by injuries. Tim Ream has got a pulled, he's got a tight thigh. Emmanuel Sabi's got a pulled groin and is out for 1 to 5 days. Jordan Morris has got a pulled groin, 2 to 9 days. That's the senior team. Under 23s, Reggie Cannon almost back. Chris Durkin had a knock, but apparently he's gotten over it. We lost Austin Trusty, which is gutting, because I would have liked to have cap-tied him if we had the opportunity to, to an injury. So we pulled up Ilan Sauter, who has English nationality and Swiss. He's working on England, but he has Swiss. And we've also called up Jalen Lindsay, who plays for Sporting Kansas City / their affiliate. That's just a... I needed a left back, and he also plays right back, which is quite hand. Or he plays right back. He's right footed, but he also can play left back. So that's been fun. It's just like, look at this: injury problems, injury worry. Down here, you go down. Injury worry. It's like, guys, stop, getting hurt. Stop, stretch, hydrate. I don't know. 5-4 odds versus 7-4 odds. This is what I have. I have no idea what to expect because from a national team standpoint, Costa Rica is the closest to us. They're 32nd. And Honduras and Panama are way down there. But it's at the youth level. So who knows, right? Like, who knows how this is going to go? We're going to start our keeper, who's Matt Sharp. He's at 92%. Reggie Cannon, not back yet. So that means... Oh, 83% Justin Lindsay is going to get the start. What about Justin Glad? How you doing, Justin? Can you play right... Can you actually play right back? Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can. That'll be fine. Or we put Tyler Adams there. I think I like that better. Tyler Adams, and then we'll bring in one of these guys. What do you do? Nothing. Mazzala? Yes. No. We need a playmaker. How about an advanced playmaker? You go right ahead. I mean, it says he's returning to fitness immediately. What's he coming back from? A concussion. We don't want to risk that, right? You don't want to risk somebody's brain. Generally a bad idea. So we're going to swap him out. So Adams is going to take the right back situation here. He could do the job. He's pretty good. It's fine. And we're going to play balance just to kind of see how it goes. It's the same style. 4-1-2-3. Robinson, left. Footed center back, right footed center back, and Adams with Durkin, Brendan Aronson, McKinney, Wea, Pulisic, and Sargent. We'd like to get off, like, I'm really hoping that Pulisic and Wea and Sargent and McKinney and Adams and aren't permanently tied to this. I think, like, again, I hope it makes sense from an under 23 standpoint. Like, we've not qualified for the Olympics, we have to qualify. They're playing a 3-1-4-2 with the DM. Curious. I can't talk to them. Yeah. It's a beta, my friends. Okay, I'll write that down. Can't give team talk. At the end of 23 level. Maybe I wasn't supposed to take over. Maybe I'm in a part of the game that doesn't exist. Actually, we are going to go positive. I think we're good enough to go positive. Come on, boys. Come on. Since I went kind of long on showing you all the players, let's just do key highlights. Christian on the right. So versatile. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. They're angry. Maybe that's what we need, some anger at US soccer, right? Like, let's get mad. Let's go kick some butt and take some names. Yeah, you're playing with the under-23s. We're going to qualify for the Olympics. Let's go. It's just Cuba. Everybody else can take care of that. We'll call you up next time against Canada. Let's go. 2 minutes in. We've already got a goal. Again, I'm showing this to you because I didn't know what to expect, right? Like, if you know, like, up the next episode, maybe the under-23s as well. Because what's interesting is it's like game, day off, game, day off, games. It's like, in 9 days or something like that, you play 3 games. So from a fitness standpoint, that's kind of curious how you manage that. Might have to get a little creative with our formations and all that. All right. Tyler Adams collects. He's in the corner. Finds a teammate. He does. Aaronson. He's got Pulisic. Pulisic or Sargent? No, it's Pulisic in front. Sargent's way up here. Redhead. There it is. Way. He's got the overlap with Robinson. They practice this with the senior team. Sargent flicks it on. He's pretty good at heading. Like it. A little clap, clap, clap. A little clap, clap, clap. Weston McKinney's unsure. Come on, Weston. How could he be unsure? It's the under 23 level. He flings it over the bar. Is this going to be a smashing? It looks early days like we're on top of it, but I want to make sure we stay on top of it. So I can't do anything. Oh, yes, I can. I just had to wait. So you can give shouts. I just have not been allowed to do my team talks. We'll have to see what happens at halftime. They're all just going to march in. I'm just going to stare at them. They're all going to march out. No one's going to say a single thing. Have a juice box and an orange slice. Enjoy. Nice switch to the field. Robinson collects. Wait, what are you doing, man? Turn around. The goal's the other way. Not a bad goal. Not a bad goal, my friends. Not a bad goal, my friends. We'll take it. It's nice to see red, white, and blue winning. I'm just saying. I just get me excited. Had somebody leave a comment on episode, I think, 2 or 3, it was like, love the energy. You're gonna find more of that on this channel if you're new and you're like, oh, who's this guy? Like, this is how I play. I get, again, what is this? So I can't shout. Okay, so we've determined, but then it like randomly pops up. Why can I only shout some of the time? But this is how I play Football Manager. It's very engaged with my saves. Brendan Aarons and has a brace from a first time volley and a set piece. Oh, that's beautiful. We've done nothing with the tactics. We've not done anything with the set piece routines or corner kicks. You know, I had to think of what I was saying. I haven't had my coffee yet, so it's... I got up at 6:30 this morning to start recording for you. For you, my friends. Who do we want to bring in? We got a 3-0 lead. We're going to take Sargent off and bring on Abobase. He's on a 6.7 complacent. It has nothing to do with him. It's like, hey, man, let's play next game, right? Like, we got a 3-0 lead. Let's not push it. So many choices now that we've got, like, our actual team playing back here. I got it. The tactics screen. I still can't talk to him. That's great. It's exactly what you want to see. It's exactly what you want to see. Christian Pulisic is playing pretty well. West McKinney, what's up with your attitude, man? Come on. Come on. And he's at 77%, but he's got a brace. So I guess it's going to be... Okay. You can play on the right as a winger. What about Buana? He's 2-star. I'm going to put the 2-star guy in. We'll take Christian off. He can play the next game. And I'm going to... See, I can't talk to them individually. Okay, that's interesting. But I can't end the team talk, which is also interesting. So we get back to it. Again, 3 games in 9 days. You got to think, you know, like, oh, halftime subs. So it's like, man, we got a 3-0 lead. Done. Job done, my friends. Take some players out. Try and rest some folks. Robinson. Tim Weah. Robinson. Robinson. Oh, hits the crossbar. And he's offside. Unfortunate. Unfortunate, my friends. We are battering them, though. I also don't like that it's kind of hard to... Okay. That one's a little bit easier to tell. I think that they should... Last year, and again, this could be a camera setting that I've messed up. It would give you kind of the sideline view, so you'd actually see the line. That says behind goal. It's clearly not behind goal. And it's kind of hard to see depending on where you're at, you know, on the pitch to see whether somebody was offside or not. Aronson has dinged the bar again. He is en fuego, my friends. He's feeling it. Okay, Weston McKennie is no longer interested in playing. That's great. He's complacent. So we're take him off. Are we? No, we're not. We're not. We're going to take off one of these guys. I think. Justin Glad is going to come on. That's going to be your final sub, my friends. Tyler Adams has had the injury, right? Not in this edition of Football Manager, but in real life. So we want to, you know, we got to watch that. Now we'll have to see who rests up in 3 days to come, you know, start the next game. Obviously, we're going to rest Weah. He won't start the next game. But hopefully we can start Sargent and Pulisic again. Tim Weah. Speak of the devil. McKennie will get a rest because he's going to play the full game. You know. You want to stay on top, but we're going to skip this. It's 4-0. It's 4-0, my friends. Aronson with a brace. Tim Weah with a brace. Loving it. Loving it. We're just playing positive. We're not even really playing attacking. Because, again, you never know. At the end of the 23 level, it gives you the nation's ranking. But, like, it's not the nation's under 23 team ranking. It's like, well, their national team, their senior team is this. They might be this good. It's like, well, who knows? They could have a golden generation coming through. Buana on the wing. Buana on the wing. Oh, curls it back right at the penalty spot. Glad, I like that. Comes forward, collect. Abobase, quite tall, can't get a hand to it. McKennie pings it wide. Now, I'm also curious, because I've not seen many people here from a crowd standpoint. What's it going to say? I guess, yeah, it could say on the fixture list how many people were there, theoretically. There's nobody there. No, I'm not. We've got a camera guy. We've got some guy in a white tracksuit. I don't know if he's involved with Honduras or not. The crowd is going crazy. They're piping in. This is like playing in a dictatorship. They're piping in the crowd noise to make it seem like there's people there. Or it's a bug. Could be. Buana. Durkin. Pings it out to Glad. Chest sit down. Justin Glad crosses it. Tim Weah go for the hat trick. Just wide. Oh. All right. We do need to look at that because there is not a single soul here. So... I'm gonna when I'm editing this, go back and go like, what were all the things we said we needed to report? Team talk is the big thing, and no one being there from a crowd standpoint is another, you could say, to be fair. Hopefully you're enjoying this series. I've had several people say like, hey, I hope you do this long term. Let's just see how it goes, I think is my take on that initially. Clean sheet intact. I'm not opposed to it. Because I think international management and a club get a save is more manageable than two club save. I can't talk to them. Or okay. So apparently, okay, the assistant is handling it. Maybe that's a thing, but I can't undelegate it or whatever. I delegated it here, but it didn't say anything. We're just gonna roll with it. We're just giving our assistant an opportunity. How many people were there? You can show me. Come on, I got custom. 345 people. Okay, so theoretically, somewhere in that stadium, there were 345 people 2 days apart. Oh, that is brutal. Who does that? That's crazy. Right. Yeah, look at the scouting report. It's amazing. I mean, we're off to a good start. Can we see the group? We can't see the group. Okay, no one else has played. Excellent. Excellent. All right, my friends, next episode. But again, I hope you don't think this is ridiculous. Qualifying for the Olympics is super important. Okay, it's like super important. Hold on. They qualify for the semifinal. Okay. I think we're off to a good start. It'd be shocking if we didn't qualify, and we also have this, so maybe let's compromise. How about that? How about that? All right, Panama. Well, let me go look at the nation. Is 68th. And Costa Rica is significantly better, 36. So what we'll do next time is we will do the Costa Rica under 23 game on key highlights. And then we will do Cuba, because those are actual games. Now, I'm curious. I've asked Serginho. I've called him a bunch. And he continues to say no. So I'm curious if he gets a call up here. That would be brutal. If he accepts a friendly call up to play against us, that would not be a popular thing in the States, you could say. But if you've enjoyed this episode, my friends, again, I know it was a lot of like, hey, let's look at all the random players we're calling in. But I hope it makes sense to you as to why I'm doing that. If we look at this as a potentially longer term save, who are the players that we're cap tying and bringing in and all that kind of stuff. So if you've enjoyed this, hit the like button. We'll see you next time as we take on Costa Rica's under 23s and Cuba, and hopefully not Serginho Dest for Holland. Have a good one.